align capital AB,
60 mm long,
has one of its extremities 20 mm in front of VP and 15 mm above HP. The line is inclined at 25 degrees to HP and 40 degrees to VP. Draw its top and front views. So this problem is also very similar to the same problem except the dimensions. A line capital AB 60 mm long. Capital AB 60 mm long means it is a true length. And its inclination with respect to HP is 25 degrees. And its inclination with respect to VB is 40 degrees. As one of its extremities means one of the end points is 20 mm in front of VB and 15 mm above HP. Now, 20 mm in front of VP is the distance when you look from the top view. We can see the distance 20 mm in front of VP. This distance when you look from the top view is projected onto the horizontal plane. Then that distance will be 20 mm here. Similarly, 15 mm above HP. So 15 mm above HP, when you look from the front view, we can see the distance above HP. This distance when it is projected onto the vertical plane, you will going to get that point as A dash, which will be 15 mm above HP. Now the line is inclined at 25 degrees to HP of 60 mm long. So we have the point here. From here, it says 60 mm long inclined at 25 degrees to HP. When it is in space, 25 degrees to HP, its inclination can be seen in VP. So obviously it should be in from the front view. So from this point A, you draw a line inclined at 25 degrees to HP such that the length of this line will be 60. So this is in space. When you look from the front view, this is being projected onto the vertical plane. That is, this capital B1 will going to become B1 dash and this capital A will going to become A dash. Now this is the line which is inclined at 25 degrees to HP and the length of the line is 60 mm. Similarly, 60 mm long inclined at 40 degrees to VP. The inclination with respect to VP can be seen in HP, so we have to look from the top view. So here the capital A, which is A, which is above HP by 15 mm. This line is inclined at 40 degrees to VP, so you draw a line which is 40 degrees inclined to VP. So that is, this inclination with respect to VP is 40 degrees in space and 60 mm long. So you are going to get the 60 mm long here. So this length. So this will be capital A and this will be capital B2. When you look from the top view, the image is projected onto the horizontal plane where you are going to have small a and small b2. So now you have the locus of B in the top view and we have the locus of B in the front view. You know that this is the true length, so obviously this will be capital A and this will be capital B, that is B1. Similarly, you are going to have this as capital A and this will be capital B2. Now, we know that this is the true length in VP. Obviously, that line is parallel to VP. So, when you look from the top view, we can see that the point A is in front of VP by 20 mm. Similarly, the point B1 is also in front of VP by 20 mm. So, then this line is parallel to VP. Since this line is parallel to VP, so we can find the true length in VP. So when it is projected, you can see that line will be true length in VP. That means whatever the line you have 80 mm here, 60 mm here, the same distance will be here also, 60 mm. Now when you look from the front view, we can see the distance above HP. We can see the distance above HP, which is both A and capital B2 is above HP by 15 mm. So now the line is parallel to HP. Since the line is parallel to HP, so when it is projected, that point will be in vertical horizontal plane, that is small a and small b2. So the inclination made by that will going to be 40 degrees. Now we need to solve the problem. When we rotate the line which is inclined to VP in space with A as center, take the radius of AB1, draw an arc such that the B1 will going to touches the locus of B in the top view. So that means this is the point where it will going to meet. So this point will be capital AB. So when it is projected in the top view, that point will be AB1, which is the line which is parallel to VB. When you look from the top view, A is in front of VP by 20 mm. So the B1 is also in front of VP by 20 mm. So when this rotated from B1 to this locus of B, so this is the point where you are going to get in space capital AB. Obviously the image is also being get rotated in horizontal plane with A as center, the radius of AB1. Draw an arc such that it will going to cut the locus of B in the top view. So you are going to get this small b and this small a. Draw a line with a dark line which is AB, and the inclination made by this will going to be the apparent inclination, which is beta. Similarly, we will going to consider the front view now, that is the true length in HP. So when you look from the front view, we can see that capital A and B2 both are above HP by 15 mm. So when it is projected, because when you look from the front view, it is projected onto the vertical plane. So A will be, which is A dash, and B2 which is here, when it is projected, it will going to become B2 dash here. So in vertical plane, both A dash and B2 dash are above HP by 15 mm. But actually that B2 dash should lie on the locus of B in the front view here. So that means we are rotating the true length which is in HP. So with capital A center, take the radius of AB2, then draw an arc, rotate this B2 such that this B2 will come and touches the locus of B in the front view. Till the locus of B in the front view. So you are going to get this point here. So when it is projected, this will going to come and touches this point here, B dash. So when you look from the front view, the B is projected, it will going to come B dash. So then you are going to get the front view. But when AB2 has been rotated in space so that it will going to come to this point B, obviously the image is also getting rotated from A dash, its center, A dash, B2 dash has the radius. It moves to the locus of B, it cuts the arc at the locus of B so that you are going to get that B dash. Then join A dash B dash with a dark line, and when you join B dash and B, both will going to lie on the same line. So this is going to be the angle inclination alpha. Now this is how we will be able to solve the problem in three dimensional analysis. Now we will going to solve this in orthographic view in a sketchbook. First we will going to draw the XY line. Mark VP above XY line and HP below XY line. Consider any point and draw a vertical projector. Then as one of its extremities is 20 mm in front of VP, from XY line you measure 20 mm below XY line and draw a horizontal line. Similarly, 15 mm above HP, so from XY line you measure 15 mm above the XY line and draw a horizontal projector, because above HP will be seen in VP. So consider any point and draw a vertical projector so that it will going to cut the points at A dash and A, and mark this point as A dash and A and capital A and capital A here. Then the line is inclined at 25 degrees to HP, that is the true length of the line is inclined at 25 degrees to HP. with this as center, that is a dash as center, by using the protractor, you measure an angle of 25 degree and draw an inclined line. Similarly, with small a as center, measure an angle of 40 degree with respect to VP, that is with respect to the horizontal, and draw an inclined line which should be thicker than the projector line. Then by using the compass, you measure the distance of 60 mm with H dash as center, cut an arc on 25 degree line, and similarly true length is same in both front view and top view. With A as center, cut an arc on this 40 degree line so that you are going to get the two locus. Mark this point as B1 dash in the front view and draw a dash dot line in the front view. Similarly, mark the point B2 here and draw a dash dot line which will going to be the true length, and write this as locus of B and this as locus of B, and this will be capital B and this is also capital B. So that means you are getting the true length. So now we mark all the dimensions, all the parameters which you have considered. Now we are going to solve the problem. We know that this is the true length in the front view. Obviously that line has to be parallel to XY line in the top view. So the front view has A dash B1 dash, the corresponding top view will be AB1. So we have already having A, but we don't have B1. So draw a vertical projector from B1 dash to the top view such that it will going to touches the locus of A in the top view. So that means A dash B1 dash, which is the true length in front view, obviously that line will be corresponding top view will be parallel to XY. So AB1 is parallel to XY. That means A is in front of VP by 20 mm and B1 is also in front of VP by 20 mm. But the top view of the endpoint B1 will lie on the locus of B here. So by using the compass with A as center, take the radius of AB1 and draw an arc such that it will going to cut the locus of B in the top view at this point B, and draw a dark line joined with A and B, small AB, and mark this point as B. Similarly, so consider the capital AB in the top view, which is the true length in HP. So obviously that line has to be parallel to HP. Here A dash is above HP by 15 mm. So obviously this B2 also should be above HP by 15 mm. That means if the line has to be in the true length in the top view, obviously that line has to be parallel to XY in the front view. So A dash and B2 dash should be parallel to XY. So A is already there, so A dash is above HP by 15 mm and we have drawn a horizontal projector. So with B2, you draw a vertical projector to the front view such that it will going to cut the locus of A in the front view, and you mark that point as B2 dash. But the front view endpoint of B must lie on the locus of B. So with A dash as center, take the radius of A dash B2 dash by using the compass. Draw an arc such that it will going to cut the locus of B in the front view to get this point small b dash. Then join A dash B dash with a dark line, and also connect B dash and B, both will going to lie on the same line. And then this will be A dash, this is the inclination with the front view inclination with respect to HP will be alpha, the top view inclination with respect to VP will be beta. You mark them. So since you have said only to draw its top and front views, so we are going to draw this. So this is how you are going to be able to solve the problem in the sketchbook. And now the same thing which can be done in the step by step. We can see here, first we have considered the front view true length. Then since this line is parallel to VP, so we are projected to the parallel to VP in the top view, because this is the true length in HP and true length in VP. So obviously that line will be parallel to VP in the horizontal plane. But we have the locus of B here. So with A as center, AB1 as the radius, you draw an arc to get the top view AB. So that is what we have shown here in the orthographic projection with a dash b1 dash. So when it is projected, you are going to get that line parallel to VP. So but the top view of the point B should be on this locus with A as center. Draw an arc to cut it on the locus of B. You are going to get this point B. Join AB with a dark line. So this will going to be the measurement, which is the apparent inclination with respect to VP. Similarly, now we are considering the true length of HP. So that is the true length of HP. So when it is true length in HP means it should be parallel to HP. So when it is projected, we can see here it is A dash B2 dash, which is parallel to HP. So that is what A dash B2 dash, which is parallel to HP. Now what we have done is we have rotated this in space such that the B will going to come and touches the locus of B here. So that is what we are getting here. So when it is rotated to touch this point, so obviously this image A dash B2 dash will also rotates by B2 dash such that it is going to cut the locus of B in the front view. So that is what with A dash as center, A dash B2 dash as the radius, you draw an arc such that it will going to cut the B dash in the locus of B in the front view. So we have joined between A dash B dash. So we have joined between A dash B dash. This is the apparent inclination with respect to HP. So this is how in step by step we can be able to solve the problem.